Hey guys, it's John from John's DIY Playground. In my first Moteino introduction, we showed you about the different types of Moteinos. Today we'll assume that you've bought one and I'm going to show you how to put it together. So stay tuned and we'll go through the steps you need to get the Moteino put together.
Now we're going to go ahead and get the Moteino prepared with the header soldering and then the FTDI connector and the antenna. I'll show you each of these steps. We've got a good tip here to share. Take a breadboard of any size and put the headers onto the breadboard ahead of time, like so. Helps keep the pins nice and square, so when you get things lined up before you solder, you've got everything in line. Just take your Moteino and put it on top like that. And then we'll go ahead and take a soldering iron. I've got a soldering station. I reviewed soldering in one of my other videos. It's a 60-watt soldering station, and you can still get away with something like a pencil type iron that doesn't have any heat control, but this one's a 60 watt and I keep it about just under halfway for as far as power. And you just take your solder, just like if you haven't soldered before. In this case, like what I like to do is to solder the first of the corners to get started, thinking that that's going to kind of keep the board held down to the pins. And if I just work the corners first, I'll get a nice start to my soldering, and then go ahead and finish pin by pin through both sides, left and right. And then we'll go ahead and do the FTDI connector. I finished up soldering all those header connections, so now FTDI connector's next. It's your own preference if you want it to be pins up or pins down. For me, I find that it's just nice and easy since I'm on the breadboard already to go pins down like this for the FTDI connector. And you can actually even just solder on top. It doesn't matter which side you solder from, but again, I just usually start on the ends. I'll solder one end and get some solder in there, and then I'll go to the other side and put some solder in on there. And once that's set, I'll just go through and hit each one of these connections with a little bit of solder and move on to the next step. I've got the FTDI connection all soldered up, as you can see here. We've taken it off the breadboard and flipped the board over. The final step here in getting the Moteino ready is to get the antenna that came with your package. It's in a very precise length for the correct frequency you need, soldered into the antenna hole. So you don't want it on the side of the pins, the antenna wire, so it can stick up and be free. So I put it on the other side, and from below I'll push through and solder onto this antenna. I like to use a pair of helping hands. As you can see, these alligator clips make it real easy. Let me get it set up in the fixture and show you how I solder that real quick. So you can see I've got the antenna wire hooked up and using this other alligator clip with the helping hands. It's holding it in place, and this is holding the board in place. The antenna wire is just sticking through that little symbol for the antenna there, you can see. And all I have to do is dab it with a little bit of solder to get that thing attached. And then our wire antenna is attached. It's just like that. We're all set and ready to start programming this Moteino.
Alright guys, that does it for today's lesson on how to solder your Moteino and get it put together. In part 3, we'll tell you how to program the Moteino and get it working as an example node to measure light and control an external LED all through your home automation gateway. So stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching. This is John from John's DIY Playground. Have a great day.